Welcome back from the break, Rams, into the playoff Pickem. Today we'll be picking who we think will win the next game, not the series. Now the Nuggets off an absolute heartbreaker last night. Let's break down that ending sequence of events real quick. And as you see right here, you know, LeBron not picking the ball up the court, making that time stay there. Jeremy Grant on him. This is something you like to see if you're the Nuggets. PJ Dozier with not a great closeout there, and AD makes it way too easy for that all-star. But this is who you want the ball in the hands of is Nikola Jokic right here, backing down AD, doing a great job. The right-handed hook, so beautiful from Nikola. And now, the last time out from the Lakers is called there. That's going to be important. Jamal Murray on LeBron James. You like this matchup if you are a Lakers fan. LeBron drives in, passes it out. One more pass. Caruso wide open for three. Doesn't go. LeBron on the tip out to Danny Green. Danny now looking for the shot. Jamal with the huge block. 2.1 seconds left. No timeouts. This is big here. As we see Anthony Davis with Mason Plumlee on him. That was a change that Michael Malone made before the timeout. Before the last play, sorry, as you saw Mason Plumlee come in for Paul Millsap. And now you see Plumlee on Davis, and you see Grant on James at the top of the key. Rondo passing the ball in with Jokic on him. And now as we run this, usually in this situation, it's switch everything. Right here, we're going to stop it again. Mason Plumlee uses that switch everything mindset that you usually have in these types of situations with 2.1. Not enough time to dribble, not enough time to get open and take advantage of a mismatch. Usually it's switch everything in these positions. Jeremy Grant doesn't switch, stays on LeBron. Mason Plumlee does switch, leading to this miscommunication. Anthony Davis, a wide open three as we're going to run the rest of the play. Nikola Jokic tries to get there, but he just can't. And that is what costed the Nuggets the game last night. And after a tough loss, who do you see taking game three, Rachel?
I think you can see it on my face, Cam, and I don't think you're going to be a little happy about this one, but I am taking the Lakers in this next game.
I knew it.
Not saying that that's the whole series, although I do still think that the Lakers can take the series, but I think that they're definitely going to be taking this game. I mean, look at that last play. It's just crazy. I don't know how they got that last play off, in all honesty. AD and Jokic were just going back and forth the rest of that. That whole last game. But that whole end of that game was Jokic with the last 12 for Nuggets and AD with the last 11 for the Lakers, and including the game winner, which was, I couldn't even believe they got that off with that little time left.
Yeah, well, for the Nuggets, really, I'm picking the Nuggets, by the way. They're not getting swept this series. They are destined to win. Have you seen the 3-1 comebacks? They're winning this game, okay? They're going to win this game, and then the Nuggets are going to be all right. Jamal Murray wakes up in the second half of series, has done it before against the Clippers, a little bit slower than you'd like him to see against Utah, woke up. Nikola Jokic is playing his absolute best. He's playing well against Anthony Davis guarding him, which is a surprise, Anthony Davis being a defensive player of the year, a former defensive player of the year. And I think the Nuggets can win this game. The series is going to be tough against a veteran Lakers team, Anthony Davis, LeBron James. The Nuggets are not getting swept. And something that a lot of people aren't going to bring up, the addition of PJ Dozier in the rotation. His defensive play that entire night was so good. And just if he can make those free throws, we would have won that game. But, you know, the Nuggets adding PJ Dozier for defense brings energy off the bench. The Nuggets are winning that next game.
You are bringing up all of my points I was about to bring up right after you. Bring it back to the defense. I mean, yeah, Denver's defense was picking it up, especially in the end there. Second half, they definitely made a much bigger improvement than the first half.
Yeah.
But,
as they always do.
But the Lakers still had, what was it, 7 blocks versus Denver's 4.
Yeah.
You talk about how AD was top defensive player. I mean, he's showing it.
Yeah.
There's moments where Jokic is taking over. I mean, that one play you showed, he definitely is. He can control it. He knows what he's supposed to do. Yeah, he's having a great game, but I don't really see them being able to push past another game, especially now with them hitting that buzzer beater so late in the game, or obviously so late in the game. But they have so. No, it was great. It was so enthusiastic. It was amazing. It was fantastic. It was just great because now the Lakers have a little bit more motivation on their backs. They already had a lot of motivation on their backs, but with that game winner, their blood's pumping. Their hearts are racing. They just want to keep going now. And I think that this is going to be able to push them a little bit farther. And talk about their free throws. Free throws really made a difference. Hit the Nuggets really hard. Only 75%, and the Lakers were 94-95% in that game. That makes a big difference for that.
Keys to the game, next series, offensive rebounds, free throws. I think we should move on from this, unfortunately.
Don't want to get you too riled up.
Yeah.
All right, well, staying on the hardwood, but switching conferences, the Miami Heat hold on to a 2-1 lead over the Boston Celtics. Who are you taking for game four, Cam?
Now, the Celtics looked good in the game that they won, right? But for me, the Celtics, their star players aren't stepping up like they need to. Kemba Walker not having a great series. It's not hard to see, but Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown, there's nights where one of them goes off, right? You see Jason Tatum and Jaylen Brown on the backboard. You see Jimmy Butler there with a great shot. But they both have to have a great night for this team to be consistent with Kemba Walker struggling. Now, if Kemba can get in the picture, all three of them have a good night. All three of them have an all-star night but not a superstar night, that's a win. But you need at least two of your all-stars to perform at superstar level to beat this defensive-minded Heat team. They're just so good on defense, you need more than one player playing spectacularly.
Now, I'm going to agree with you, and I'm going to go with Heat in this coming game. But I'm kind of against what you're saying about Kemba Walker. I mean, he and Jaylen Brown and Jason Tatum all went over 20 points in that last game.
Yeah.
And it kind of adds to your point already that you're saying that if two of them go off, they're going to win that game.
Yeah.
So, yeah, I agree with that part. But I don't think that he's having such a horrible series. I think that he's just kind of having little off moments throughout the games. And last night, or in their last game, it definitely was not there. I mean, he was over 20 points already for himself.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, that's definitely what helps them win the game. But they need to contain Brown, and they need to contain Tatum.
Absolutely.
To get that game. And, yeah, you're going to have – the Heat's good with their offense, and they're great with their defense, but Jimmy Butler can't do everything himself. Mm-hmm. You need guys like Tyler Hero to come out of the woodworks and have one of his great games like he's had in the past couple of weeks.
Yeah.
But definitely I think they need to focus on containing Tatum and Brown more specifically than anybody else.
The Heat, obviously, kind of the surprise of this playoffs, right? You know, you thought they'd do well, didn't think they'd beat the Bucks. A lot of people didn't. And now they're here showing why they deserve to be in the Eastern Conference Finals and playing tough ball against this great Celtics team. But, you know, going over the ice now, the Stanley Cup Finals have begun, and the Dallas Stars have an early 1-0 lead. What is your game two pick?
All right, for this one, I'm going to go with the Stars. Yeah, it's kind of early in their series. It's only a 1-0 difference right now. But for me, the star of that last game was Anton Khudobin. I mean,
words
he
right
had 35 saves on 36 attempts. That is insane. Yeah, he didn't get the shutout, but if you see some of these highlights, I don't know how he sees this puck the entire time because I can't even see it, and I'm farther away and probably could see better than he could with all the players that are standing right in front of him. But some of these saves are absolutely ridiculous. And he had 22 in only the third period.
Mm-hmm.
But, I mean, that's just fantastic. That's a lot of trust in your goalie and in your defense.
Yeah.
And I think that the only way for them to kind of reel themselves in and have a better game in the next game, even though they won 4-1, I mean, it wasn't a bad game at all.
Yeah.
I think that their offense kind of needs to pick it up a little bit, especially going into the third period and way later into the game, because you can't have all of the pressure and all of the play on your goalie the entire time.
You know, I agree. And something that they forget about Khudobin, a lot of people do, he's a backup. He is a backup goalkeeper playing like he is one of the best in the entire National Hockey League. And for me, it's the Stars. Or not the Stars, the Lightning Stars, I'm sorry. Braden Point not playing up to the potential we know he can play to this series. Obviously, not very much time in the series, but didn't play as well as we know he could game one. And Kucherov also not playing well as well as he could in that game one either. You need more offense from the Stars from the Lightning if they're going to be able to win this.
Absolutely. Well, I'm going to add one last thing to that, and I'm just going to say that since the Stanley Cup Finals have gone into a 7-game series playoff bracket, which was in 1939, the team that has won their first game has basically a 75% chance of winning the whole thing. Not since 1939. I think that's definitely going to be an outstanding stat for the Stars. I think that's going to help them a little bit. Well, Rams, that is all the time that we have for tonight. But to stay updated, head on over to sports_CTV on Twitter and Instagram. I'm Rachel Hallam.
And I'm Cam Evig. Make sure to tune in tomorrow to catch Hunter Fillmore. Breakdown this week of fantasy football. Good night, Rams.